What's going on, you guys? So, three conversation starters that you can have with any girl, anywhere, anytime. Okay. So I think the best ways to start a conversation is kind of specific to the situation. For instance, if somebody came in on like a train or whatever, plane or something like that, he comes on and is talking really loudly and obnoxiously to other people and like swearing, maybe telling a dirty story or something like that, I could turn to the girl sitting next to me and say, I bet he's talking to his mother. And she probably burst out laughing because that's ridiculous, okay? That would be good because it would be specific to the situation that we're both experiencing, this obnoxious guy getting on the plane. Now, I know a lot of people aren't really, or the situation isn't always there for that, so that's why I'm giving you guys these particular openers. Now, I have a bigger list of these in the practical approaching system, and I break down how to kind of use the situation to your advantage like I did in that previous example, which is going to be a much better way to start a conversation, but I don't have time to do that here. So if you want to get access to that, the link is in the description box below. Okay, so let's talk about the three openers right now. Okay, the first one that I'm going to give you is an opinion opener. Basically, it looks like this. You walk up to the girl and you say something like, hey, me and my friends were talking back there, and we were just wondering, we wanted to get a female opinion on this. Who do you think lies more, men or women? Okay, that's a great opener because it's like, you know, it's a classic debate, you know, who lies more, men or women? Nobody knows, okay? I think they both lie a lot. but usually those types of psychology questions or opinion openers are great to have. They're great for groups of women. You know, if you see a large group around, you can ask this question. It usually gets a fun discussion going, okay? So that's a great way to start the conversation. Okay, two, another way to start the conversation would be to ask her a question. You can do the whole, hey, I'm new to the area type question. You'd be like, hey, you know, I just moved here and I'm kind of like walking around. Do you know where the nearest Starbucks is? Or do you know where the nearest XYZ. Easy way to start the conversation. Pretty much after that, I would ask her if she's been in the area for a long time, okay? Then you can talk about where you two have come from. You can move it into another conversation that can, you know, be something that's going to lead somewhere as opposed to you just getting the directions and then her being like, okay, cool, thanks, bye, and then leaving, okay, after she gives them to you, all right? So that's one another way that I would use, okay? Don't use that one a whole lot because I like to open, you know, a little bit more, you know, going after what I want, but it definitely works. As long as the opener doesn't really matter. It's like kind of how you lead it into something. So leading into that would definitely work. Okay, and finally, the third one is that you literally go in more direct, where you basically say something like, hey, I was just walking over there getting a coffee and I saw you and I thought you were really cute and I just wanted to come say hi. Hi, my name's Lloyd. Cool. So that's one way of doing it, okay? A lot of guys prefer to do this because they like going direct. Me personally, I would prefer to not go direct in that way. When you come out and declare that the person is cute, you know, it puts a lot of pressure on them. You know, I wouldn't, if you can compliment them on something else besides their looks, I think that would work a lot better. Complimenting them on their style, you know, maybe you're really in shape or something like that, or whatever it is, try not to come off too creepy, obviously, that can be a lot better than, you know, just complimenting someone on their looks. All right, something they've worked towards, something that they clearly spent time doing, those tend to do the best, okay? Now, after you've said that, given that compliment, make sure you talk to her normally. You can even give a little time constraint in there, just like, hey, I just wanted to come say hi for a minute. That way she knows you're not gonna be hanging around there forever and she's not thinking of a way to get out. So I use all of those things at my disposal. Now, again, these are not the usual things that I say. The usual things that I say are situation specific, but literally, if I can't think of anything, I'll just walk up to her and be like, hey, you know, I was just walking down here kind of exploring and I thought I'd come say hi. My name's Lloyd. Nice to meet you. Okay. Easy things. Doesn't really matter. Kind of gauge her if she's trying to leave or something like that. Ask her if she's trying to leave or if she's busy or whatever it is. That way you're not keeping her occupied when she's clearly trying to get out of there. And then, yeah, keep the conversation going and talk about her interests. And, you know, that will lead it to something else where you guys can see each other in the future, which is ultimately probably why you walked up in the first place, to find out if she's cool and if you guys should hang out together. So that's my advice for you guys. Those are the three things. Again, I talk more about this in the practical approaching system. If you want to get access to it, the link is in the description box below. I cover this super in-depth, step-by-step, exactly how to do what I'm telling you guys about. Guys are already using it and they're already getting success from it. So I would highly recommend that you guys take advantage of the deal that I'm offering right now, because like I said, I'm probably going to be closing sales at the end of tonight. So thanks for watching, you guys. If you made it to, consider subscribing, and good luck out there.